what do you see the U.S. economy doing? Is if you were sitting at the Fed and telling, you know, making your vote one way or the other, what would you be voting for, Constance?
On the hot seat. I guess I'd be voting to pause right now, but watching very closely with certainly a tilt towards examining the value of and the trade-off, I guess, between holding one's fire now so that you have ammunition for later versus doing another cut now and how much it would impact the economy. And I think that's really, for those that believe that the U.S. economy is at risk, that is the real question.
Unconventional tools are going to be discussed again very much here. We're not in a great recession. We're not in a financial crisis, and every central bank in the world practically seems to be talking about them now. But is there really that much you can do now with quantitative easing? Does forward guidance really have much to do, particularly if your goal is to boost inflation?
Well, look, forward guidance did a lot this year. I mean, look at what happened when the stance was shifted to we're going to pause. Look at how much the long end of the yield curve came out, and as you noted earlier, the short end of the yield curve. And look, this happens with lags. We're just now seeing the effect of that forward guidance on the actual economy. Let's give it some time to see how it plays out. Do I think the Fed can prevent business cycles from occurring? No, I think we will still have business cycles. But at this juncture, can they help extend the expansion a bit? They probably can.
What do you think is going to happen to bond yields? That New York Fed study out saying today that they probably aren't going to go above, it's a survey, above 2% for the next 10 years. It feels like we're in a new world of low yields, low inflation, maybe low growth. What does that mean for central banks?
Well, I think we're in a completely new paradigm. We have never before had this mixture of increasing longevity and lower birth rates. And the whole world is organized so that we have younger people coming along to boost the economy and to fill government coffers that allow them to help provide for retirement for our older populations. And that entire paradigm has completely shifted. It is no longer sustainable. We know that when you have increased longevity and a majority of your population is an older population, you have much lower inflation rates, much lower growth rates. It's impacting everything from investment to consumption. And of course, that impacts where rates are and what monetary policy is doing.